ahead here, November is American Diabetes Month. And right now, there are millions of Americans who are living with diabetes or are at risk for developing the disease.
So coming up after the break, we're going to talk to Dr. Sharon Thompson about living a healthier lifestyle to help prevent that.
Hey, we are always trying to keep you healthy around here. You're part of our family, right? So we got to talk about American Diabetes Month for the month of November. Diabetes is a disease that impacts 1 in 10 Americans. So joining us this morning to talk about how to prevent it and also how to live with it is Dr. Sharon Thompson from Central Phoenix Obstetrics and Gynecology. Thanks so much for being here this morning. You delivered a lot of babies this weekend.
A lot of babies this weekend. Fall is a popular time.
Well, we appreciate you making a little bit of time in between that that exciting work of yours. So I was just at the Juvenile Research Diabetes Research Foundation gala this weekend, raising money for type 1 diabetes to try to figure out a cure for this. It is devastating to see these little children who are coping with the responsibility of monitoring their insulin to keep themselves alive.
Yes.
They're tiny.
Yeah. Type 1 diabetes can be diagnosed anywhere from birth to usually early 20s is the latest we'll catch it. And these kids are a special group because they have no insulin. Their body has no capacity to manage sugar, and so they have to get it from the outside. Key thing for type 1 diabetes is for parents to know what the signs might be, because as you mentioned, these children can be quite small. They can't tell you. So for parents to know, frequent thirst, insatiable hunger, kids who might be exhibiting signs of feeling faint or passing out, that's not normal. You want to get them checked out. So know some of the signs.
They're at risk of going into a coma.
Absolutely. Yes.
That's living in constant stress as a family.
Fortunately, these days, there are good treatments, and we were talking about before we came on about their insulin pumps that can deliver insulin around the
constantly.
Clock. Yes, in the old days, you had to do injections all the time. So now these kids have a much more user-friendly management system.
Okay, and that's type 1 diabetes, and I was surprised to hear also that many people who come who get diagnosed with type 1 have no family connection or history to this.
Absolutely. So type 1 is a different disease from type 2. There's definitely a component of it that has to do with an overactive immune system, and there are probably some other reasons why people can get it as well. It has to do with a defect of cells in the pancreas. And in fact, type 1 diabetes can be cured with a transplant of a pancreas. And not everyone's eligible for that, but some people are cured that way.
So type 2 is the one that is triggered somewhat by lifestyle.
Yes.
Okay.
Yes. So type 2 diabetes is a type that you tend to get diagnosed with a little bit older age. It's the one that's associated with family history, like you mentioned, and obesity, overweight can be associated with type 2 diabetes.
Okay, so we were talking about some of the other risk factors for type 2 diabetes. If you have gestational diabetes while you're pregnant, that increases your risk.
So gestational diabetes is another type of diabetes that pregnant women can get while pregnant, and it tends to go away when the pregnancy is over. However, if you have gestational diabetes in any pregnancy, you have a 50% chance of getting it later in life. So that's a heads up to you to be screened every single year for diabetes.
So you can be screened with a blood test.
You can be screened with a blood test. There are several, but a fasting glucose, you don't eat in the morning and get the test first thing, is one of the tests that can be done.
Okay, so when you're talking about the later in life type 2 diabetes, the onset of that, what signs are you seeing? How do you know that that this is coming up?
So many, many people have no symptoms whatsoever. So risk factors are a way to know that you should be screened. So the symptoms can be the same, though. They can be, you know, you're feeling hungry all the time, you're losing weight even though you're eating well. You can feel faint, like you're gonna pass out. That can be a first sign for some people. And so getting screened, though, for type 2 is probably key, because many people will not have symptoms at all.
And then what are the risk factors? Should it go undiagnosed or untreated?
So diabetes is a very serious disease. I always say there are several things that you always take seriously: chest pain and diabetes and hypertension. And diabetes can lead to heart disease. It can lead to problems with your nerves. Most of us are familiar with diabetic amputations because your circulation is not as good. And so your toes, your feet don't get the the blood supply that they need. Kidney disease is a very common consequence of untreated diabetes. Very serious disease and very controllable.
Okay.
So you definitely want to know if you have it. You can change. Many people are controlled with some diet change.
Okay.
Your body is having a hard time handling sugars, so you reduce the sugars in your diet. Exercise can really help quite a bit, and there are lots of medications that can help.
Dr. Thompson, thank you so much.
Oh, you're welcome.
Great to see
definitely
you.
Definitely get diagnosed so you can get treated.
Yes, we'll share this information on AZ Family. We'll repost the interview.